I just want to clarify something right up front. I didn't run them off. Okay? I liked them up here. What about y'all? I think they looked good up here. But they came up here and then they were told they needed to be there. I didn't do that. Anyway, good morning. It's good to see all of you. Happy Father's Day. Men, take a bow. Take a bow, men. We're so thankful for all of you men who have helped with raising children and influencing children of this church. When we baptize a child in the United Methodist Church, the parents take a vow, but so does the congregation. And the men help raise children in the church as well. So we're happy that you're here today, and we want to honor you in a very special way. Before I begin the service, though, there have been some announcements screening on the board, along with a lot of photos from our week of Vacation Bible School. I've got the uniform on. What do you think? There's a lot of the uniform. A lot of the uniform around the room. Even though Wade and I had to take off Tuesday unexpectedly, we weren't here very much. I know it was a wonderful week, and so we're thankful to be back here this morning. If you would please be so kind as to pass the registration pads and sign your name. Pass it all the way down the pew in which you're sitting so that those sitting next to you can sign in. And know that John and I pray over those things. If you have a prayer concern or something you'd like to lift up, that's a great place to write those down as well so that we can review those. Our Vacation Bible School has been wonderful, and in a few minutes you're going to see a little more about that. I think Sharon Pale, nope, doing it later? Okay, we're doing that later. Never mind, scratch that. Well then let's stand for the call to worship. Won't you join with me in a moment? Oh Lord our God, the majesty of your name fills the earth. Your glory is higher than the heavens. We gather to praise you. Oh Lord, our Lord, the majesty of your name fills the earth. Your glory is higher than the heavens. We gather to celebrate you. Oh Lord, our Lord, the majesty of your name fills the earth. Your glory is higher than the heavens. We gather to worship you. We gather to worship our God. All praise, honor, majesty, and power belongs to our creating God. Amen. And now let us take a moment and greet one another in the name of Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Would you join me in prayer? Almighty God, we do thank you so much for the great new morning. We thank you for this morning's rain showers that just poured your blessed water on this earth and bring us new life. We thank you for the new life that our church has gone through this week as the children have run and played and laughed and learned about you. But God, we have so many in our church who are in desperate need of your help and your mercy and in your grace. We pray for Peggy Adcox, Courtney Allen, Matthew Aiden, Ray Baumgart, Bess Blitch, Dale and Mary Carey, Neilan Carter, Bob Cassingham, Dina Day, Virginia Davis, Leland and Nelvia Fisher, Nancy Fowler, Stephanie Fowler. We celebrate the birth of Jordan Wayne Fusler. We pray for Virginia Harris and Larry and Hazel Hamlin. Continued strength for Haley Hibbler and Pete Hibbler, Paul and Carrie Hicks, Jim Coleman, Cecilia Lavender, Alan Lindgren, Tiffany Lucia, Ginger McCann, Mark Oker, Jill McDaniel, Kathleen Turner, Jaylee Metzger, Isabella Messick, Caitlin Norton, Joanne Page, Carol Parker, Blaine Powell, James Powell, Vicky Rapp, Guy Robinson, Helen Reeves, B. Sanders, Ori Sanford, Deborah Schnelli, Kevin Statler, Jim Sutherland, Dwayne Thompson, Patrick Walsh, Wanda Wallace, Jack Wesner, Wade White, Bud Whitehead, Sam Wilson, Billy Wimberly, John Woolley, Elnora Wooten. We pray, dear God, for those who we love and know that are suffering with cancer. We pray, God, for healing in each of these situations. We pray for John Berlin and Jimmy Bibles, Joe Boyd, Travis Campbell, Norma Davis, Dean Dearmont, Bob Dyer, Ellen Ely, Carson Eubank, Jeannie Flynn, Mary Gurno, Ray Hufford, David Inman, Henry Jackson, Bill Johns, Sherry Jones, Carolyn Kendrick, Marla Leeper, Katie Meyer, Kevin Mott, Debbie Pack, Charlie Phillips, Ray Pride, Charlie Robertson, Ellie Rodriguez, Kathy Rose, Shelley Stewart, Hope Swigert, Cindy Walden, Kathy Sones, Tammy Whitman, and Holly McQuarrie. And now, God, these are the ones that we know of. Now we lift up those nearest to our hearts this morning. God, we thank you so much that you hear our prayers. We ask, Lord, that you be with each and every name that we have lifted up. We pray for strength and healing and most of all, your presence. God, as a country, we come together and pray for the Emmanuel African Methodist Episcopal Church in South Carolina. We ask, God, that you be with those families that have been affected by this ridiculous tragedy. Lord, we pray for our country. We pray, God, that this spirit of hate, this spirit of racism, the spirit of anger is taken away. We pray, God, that we as individuals and we as a church and we as a community can be a light of hope and peace and a light of love. We thank you, Jesus. And now, God, you've blessed us in so many ways. And we return to you our gifts of tithes and offerings. We ask, God, that you take these gifts and you help us. Help us to be a light to this world. Be with those who so desperately need you. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you for your love. And in response to all that you have done for us, we pray the prayer your Son taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
I'm so thankful for so many things today, obviously. I'm so thankful that in our family we have a new grandson. That's awesome. But I'm also so thankful for all, as I said earlier, all the men in this church and beyond this church who reach out and touch and help raise little children. I'm thankful for the fathers that we know, the uncles, the grandpas, all of those men who are so vital in raising a child. And when I'm thankful, I say, thanks be to God. Just stand up. Stand up. Miscue. Now, as you're being seated, gentlemen, could you remain standing because the children have a gift for you as fathers. All gentlemen.
Good morning, Vacation Bible School! All right, thank you and welcome to SunSpark Labs. We've had an exciting and educational week. We've had over 230 to 250 children in this building every single day this week, which is wonderful. Throughout this week, we've been sharing with them little messages of God's Word, and God's plan for each of us, and the special message that God loves each and every single one of us. And with that, I want to introduce the people who have helped us throughout this week. Professor Peter Petrie, lab assistant Sally, and stage manager Sam. Give them a round of applause.
Hey, good morning, everyone. So happy you could join us today. Please give a warm welcome to my technical assistant, Sam. And please give a warm welcome to my lab assistant, Sally.
Hello. Okay there, Professor. We'd also like to welcome all of our lab assistants who helped in SunSpark's lab this week. Up here, please give them a welcome. And all of you who volunteered this week to make this possible for the children in our church and in our community. Please stand up. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, we had a cool, cool week this week with really cool demonstrations. And we used almost every one of these things. Actually, we used all of these and even more in our demonstrations. And we had fun games, and we had really cool crafts, and we had yummy, yummy snacks too, didn't we?
And most important of all, we learned amazing true things from the Bible.
That's right. We discovered God's plan for you, for me, and for every one of us. So,
we've got a song all about God's plan.
You do? I'd love to hear it.
We all would. Go ahead and sing it, kids.
Sorry.
God's plan! God's plan!
So, since you all were here all week for our demonstrations, I bet you remember our demonstration of gravity.
We sure do.
Can you give us a gravity demonstration right now?
You bet.
Oh, wow, that's astonishing and amazing. Gravity's still working.
Principle says that when God made the world, he created all the scientific laws that govern it, laws like gravity.
We've been discovering all kinds of amazing principles that God created. And we've discovered some amazing answers to questions we've asked.
I have one of those questions here. The question reads, who made the world and who made me? Our answer, God created the universe, made you, and loves you.
We have a song all about how God made the world and us.
Thank you.
song tells us that it was God's plan.
And what a great plan. You know, God made the world and everything in it. And he made us different from all the rest of his creation.
God made us to be like him so that we could love him and have a close relationship with him. But something happened that changed everything.
That reminds me of what we learned about cause and effect.
We have a spark principle about cause and effect. Whatever we do, a cause, has a result, an effect. Whenever we sin, the effect is separation from God.
Here's an example of cause and effect. I'll just turn this on. And,
that's
the wrong one.
And plug it in.
Power helps. Ah, there we go. The faster air moves around an object, the less the air pushes down on it. Gravity is pushing down on the ball at the same rate the air is pushing up on it. That's the cause. The effect is that the ball hovers in the airstream. And holding the tube over the ping pong ball will cause it to just get stuck in it. Or with this tube, shoot up. Here's another demonstration of cause and effect that the kids really love this week. If you have sensitive ears, you might want to cover them while we do this. Oh, sorry.
This could be loud. Cover your ears.
Ready? Oh, did you want to do this? I'm sorry.
Sin is the Bible word for when we do things that are wrong.
Let's sing our song about how sin separates us from God.
Thank you.
tells us about another part of God's plan.
And unfortunately, sin or doing the wrong things gets in the way between us and God. But God promised to send someone that could fix that problem.
So for hundreds and hundreds of years, the people waited and waited for this person to come.
Our spark principle about motion tells us that an object at rest stays at rest until a force puts it into motion. People were stuck in sin until Jesus came to put God's plan into motion.
And we just demonstrated motion.
What do you think, Noah?
You just showed what happens when you apply force to an object. It moves, but I want to demonstrate what happens when you don't apply a force. It doesn't move.
And that's just like people. We were stuck in our sin, not moving forward, not getting closer to God. We were just stuck until Jesus came.
The next question reads, what is God like? Our answer says, when you read about Jesus in the Bible, you know more about God.
We can know about God from what Jesus said and what Jesus did. And God gave us his word in the Bible so we can read about Jesus and learn more.
Let us sing our song based on the Bible verse John 14:6-7. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really knew me, you would also know my Father.
Reminds us of
so God gave us his word through the Bible and sent Jesus so we could know him.
That's not the only reason God sent Jesus. The most important reason God sent Jesus was so that we could be transformed into members of his family.
We have a spark principle about transformation. This principle states that transformation occurs when something new is introduced to an existing object and changes the object. Jesus changed us.
Hey, you know what? We better wear these safety glasses before we demonstrated the transformation that Jesus made in us. You're pretty close. You're pretty close, Bailey. Get your protective lenses on, and we can demonstrate this. The way we demonstrate this is we're going to put some dry ice into this container. The dry ice is made of frozen carbon dioxide, so when it hits the warm water, the carbon dioxide changes into carbon dioxide gas and water vapor and makes a cool, cool cloud.
By adding dishwashing liquid, which is a cleanser, we can transform this liquid into something else. It's coming.
Go ahead, you can touch the bubbles. They won't hurt you, but don't ever touch dry ice. Do not try this at home.
Jesus can transform us. In 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 18, the Bible tells us, Christ died for sins once and for all time. The one who did what is right died for those who don't do right. He died to bring you to God.
Jesus' death and resurrection gave us life. It transformed us into members of God's family.
How about this one?
Okay, wait, what? What do I say?
Do this one.
We have a song about being a member of God's forever family.
Oh boy, got a song. Okay, y'all stand up. We have a good song
now.
Okay, we do have a song. These bubbles are truly amazing.
Thank you.
us about an important part of God's plan.
God's plan to save us.
But that's not the end of the story.
Before Jesus left Earth, he gave instructions to his friends. Jesus wanted them to go all over the world, telling others about him and sharing God's love the way he had.
One of our Spark principles tells us that a chain reaction is a series of events caused by the one before. Sharing God's love with others can start a chain reaction and go on and on.
Hey, let's have our own chain reaction. When I say go, I want the people on the ends over here on the left-hand side, the end person, y'all stand up, as a matter of fact. Everybody stand up. This is going to be a good chain reaction. If you can, stand. Okay, I want the persons on the end over here on the left-hand side, the person on the end of each row, I want you to turn to your right and give a high five to the next person to you. That person, in turn, will turn to your right and give a high five to the person next to that person, and so on all the way. You'll even jump across the aisles with your high fives, and that will continue all the way over till you get to the far right-hand side. Okay, now do this when I say go. Ready? Go! Pass it around, pass it on, pass it on. Pass it on, pass it on, pass it on. Wow, back row is really hot, hot passing it on. Oh, look at the second row. My gosh, they are really, really passing it on. First row, even faster. Wow, look at you guys. Okay, you can sit down once you've passed it, please. If you care to. Thank you.
That's the way it works with God's love. When you share God's love with someone, then that person might want to share it with someone else. And then that person can share it with someone else. And on it goes.
One of our questions asks, so what do I do now? Our answer says, you can live as God's child and show his love to others.
Something tells me that our lab assistants might have a song about God's love. Am I right about sharing God's love?
You
Am
bet.
Am I right?
Come on, everyone. Let's sing.
tells us that we are part of God's plan.
So we've learned about five different parts about God's plan. One.
Of God's plan. Come on, Lab Assistants, what is God's plan?
Okay. Would you all mind sitting down for just one more moment? You've done such a wonderful job on those songs. So what I'd like to do is thank everyone for coming to share this week's VBS and recap what the kids and we all explored. First, I'd like to thank our great lab assistants, all of you lab assistants. That's right. Next, I would like to thank all of you volunteers. Would you stand up if you volunteered for even 1 minute of duty on this week? Thank you, please. Stand up. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you. Now I want to thank all of those people who didn't stand up, but you're here and you know who you are. You contributed prayer, you contributed other resources and activity that without you, this week could not have happened. So we want to give yourselves a hand, please. Now then, I'd like for you to thank my lab technician, Bill. And my lab assistant, Kate. The technical staff at the back of the room and all the technical staff handing us things. Only a couple more here that we really, really, really do need to thank. Let's please not forget to thank Steve Allen McDonald, who is Mr. Mission. Al, stand up for us. Allen, thank you. Sorry about that. Okay, let's see. Only a couple left. Mary Ann Fletcher guided and directed this skit stuff from bad to worse to what you saw today. Let's give her a big hand. She had a lot to do, I'm telling you. Okay, and there's one other without whom none of this could possibly have happened. Let's all thank Jesus Christ. Well, that's a wrap for our part.
Awesome. Great. Les needs to be thanked too, right? Or whatever his name was. But we do have two very special people that we have to thank. The two people who made it happen this year that were our directors. So would Tracy and Sharon, or Sharon? Or Sharon? Oh, come on. So Tracy Goggins and Sharon Pell were our directors this year, and we want to thank them very much. They have done an incredible job. I can honestly say it. I have seen a lot of them here, and this was the best one we've ever had. So I want to thank them personally and on behalf of the whole church. We already gave them gifts so they don't get two. But thank you guys so much for all you've done.
You're welcome. Yeah, you're good.
And we do ask you that maybe this is God's place, that God's calling you to be a part of this family, or if you just need some time of prayer, we're going to stand together and sing, and as we sing this song, if this is where God is calling you to be a part of the family, or you just need some time alone to pray at the altar, we ask you to do that. So please stand and join us in our closing hymn.
Thank you.
Amen. And we want to thank you for joining us today as we celebrated Vacation Bible School. To all of the parents of these beautiful children who don't normally come to church here, we thank you for letting them be part of us this week. And for those who are part of this church every week, we thank you especially. Don't y'all want to say thanks to Mom and Dad for letting us come this week? Why don't y'all clap for Mom and Dad? Can y'all clap? They are so cute, aren't they? And we do pray that God takes you from this place and you go and share that love that Jesus has with you. We're going to keep them up there so you guys can come and get them versus letting them go free for all here at the end. So, but if you would, are we doing a song? All right, would you grab hands if you're comfortable with the person next to you and sing our closing song?